Awesome, awesome. Okay, so wonderful. Okay, so could we please, please introduce yourselves?
Well, I'm Arielle, aka Gaming Mermaid.
My name is Megan. Megan plays on YouTube.
I'm Alex, and people call me Inquisitor Master.
I'm Azarina, Ashley the Unicorn.
Hello, everyone. I'm Leah Ash.
Awesome. You guys have so many fans out here. We love to hear. So I just really want to ask you guys, what do you love about Roblox? What's your favorite thing about Roblox?
My favorite thing is the fact that you can play the game on multi-platforms and you can interact with people in real time. I just really like communicating with people and getting to know my viewers and people that want to join me and, you know, sharing stories together and stuff like that. I just really love the communication aspect.
Yeah, personally, I love how accessible it is. Like, anybody can get involved with developing experiences, creating UGC, or even creating content. Like, it's open to everybody, and I think that's my favorite thing about it, is anybody can pick it up super easy.
I can dress up my character as anything I want and do anything I want in any games. I can make any role play in the world, and that's why I love Roblox.
I like Roblox because there's millions of games to play and a lot to choose from, so there's never-ending content to play.
And I absolutely love being able to connect with anyone around the world. It's so fun.
Awesome. Okay, so I feel like, how did you guys get started? Like, do you guys remember, like, how did you get started? What made you want to create content on Roblox? Leah, would you like to answer that?
Yeah, actually, San and I, we were playing a bunch of random games, and we came across Roblox, and we were like, this is so much fun, and it actually did super well, and I connected with the game so much, and it just stuck, and yeah, it's been amazing.
Awesome.
I used to play Roblox as a kid, so it was just a game that I always played, and I really enjoyed it, and yeah.
Well, 6 years ago, I found Roblox by a game called Titanic, and that's where I filmed my first ever Roblox roleplay, and ever since then, I've been playing it, and I've been loving it.
Honestly, I was down and out about to have to go out into the real world after college, and I wasn't really sure what I was going to do. I had a friend, his name was Moose, and he was talking about how big Roblox was and how many people were involved in it and how fun it was going to be. So I decided to check it out after that, and it turns out it was a lot of fun. I came from doing The Sims, and that was very monotonous, just over and over and over again. But I found that with Roblox, there's millions of experiences on there, and there was so much to choose from and so much to do, keeping it fresh all the time.
Yeah, that's actually my same experience, because I was doing Sims as well. And like you said, it's monotonous, and I felt like I was doing the same thing over and over. And then I heard this game called Roblox, so I'm like, let me check it out. And I really enjoyed it, and I made some of my best friends on there, so.
Yeah, I love that. I heard, like you just said, that you started with a Titanic game. So I'm really curious about now, and I know a lot of you guys play different experiences, and your fans love certain type of experiences that you play, but I'm really, really curious to know, what is your favorite, all-time favorite Roblox game or experience?
For years now, it's been Royal High, because Royal High has inspired my aesthetic. It's inspired the way that I dress now.
I know, you dress so nice.
Thank
I love the style.
Thank you.
I play Bloxburg a lot, so probably Bloxburg.
Yes, I love Bloxburg and Royal High, because I love dressing up like a princess. That's my favorite.
My favorite was Royal High as well, but before that it was Enchantix High School for mermaids and fairies, and I'm a mermaid, so of course I love that, and I just love how it's so cute and creative for me. Like, I can make my own original role plays and stories on there, so I really enjoy that one.
My favorite experiences are the ones that we've made ourselves, because we have full control over what goes in it and what's on it. It's completely customizable, so why wouldn't it be my favorite? Overlook Bay, anything made by Wonderwork Studio, Trader, Timmy, all the really fun things to come.
Yeah, I love that. yeah, self-promo. So I have a really interesting question. Someone had asked, do you guys feel like the things that you do in real life, like your interests, your passions, does that reflect what you do on Roblox?
I'd say so, definitely. I mean, I grew up dressing up, like, loving princess dress-up games, so I was attracted to Royal High, and I love decorating, so Bloxburg was perfect for me, so yeah, I think so.
I used to want to be an interior designer, so Bloxburg was the first one that I really liked. I also want to do architecture and stuff, so it was a perfect route.
That totally makes sense. And how would you explain, I'm just saying, like, maybe some people out there, what is Bloxburg? Like, what is that? What do you do in there?
You can, like, play, like, you can build houses, homes, anything that you want, like, literally build anything. You can also role play on it, anything, yeah.
Yeah, I feel like that's perfect. Like, interior designing, that totally makes sense. What about you, Alex?
What was the question?
The question's like, does the things that you do in real life, like your passions, does that reflect to what you like to do in Roblox?
Of course, all the time. I literally dress up my character just like me, just the way that I look like in real life, except I used to have blonde hair, but I dyed it brown. But yeah, definitely I've gotten inspired by Roblox.
Yeah, I love it.
That's like such an interesting question because I've grown up like playing video games since I was two. So it's like, I guess it's like I'm just continuing to play games all the time, so I don't know if it directly relates. I mean, I play Adopt Me a lot, and I do have 5 pets, like, in real life, like, 3 cats and 2 dogs.
Oh my gosh, so many.
We live in a zoo, but I love it.
I like, love a good zoo.
I love it. I can't stop. So, I mean, it's kind of a complicated question. So as you play games, you play Roblox, and yeah, that's all I like to do in real life, play games.
Yeah.
So I've been always into art, and in high school, I took like all the fashion construction, like making my own fashion designs and stuff like that. So I really like that now you can create your own custom content in Roblox. So yeah.
I love that. Megan, you actually touched on this already. I'm curious, does anyone else make their own experiences? Has anyone else?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yes?
I have a obby. It's the Leah Ash obby, and it's like pink. It's like a fantasy world with boba. It's so fun.
I love boba.
Yeah, me too.
So, Megan, do you want to touch a little more on that?
Like, sure.
Why did you do that?
Super interesting question. So back in 2000, I think it was 19, late 2018, I decided that it was really difficult to create the roleplay stories I wanted to create on some of the games I was playing. I felt like, you know, maybe you couldn't hide UI, you couldn't dress exactly how you wanted. So I was like, why don't we just make our own game? So we hired a studio to help us out, but then we ended up deciding it was better if we just wanted to do it ourselves. So me and my husband, Zachary Letter, we co-founded Studio Wonderworks. I'm really proud to say that we employ 70 people in Arlington, Texas.
Oh my gosh, wow.
I know, like, it's actually really great because there's so many people that graduated. Thank you. There's so many people. Oh my God, such a stage, I know. No, I'm kidding. There's just so many people who graduate in like the art industry. So I went to college for art, and maybe there's 300 people graduating with graphic design. There's not 300 jobs for graphic designers out there. So we're glad to kind of add to the mix of people who could go into game design or go into game development with their passions. And so we're really proud about that.
I love that. Yeah. That's awesome. How do you guys choose which games or experiences you're gonna stream or make video content for? How do you guys decide that? I know because there's so many, I'm like overwhelmed sometimes when I'm on the Roblox site. I don't even know what I would like. So how do you guys know which ones to choose?
Well, listening to the fans, reading the comments, seeing what they want. I know that I do this a lot on Instagram. I'll post a story. What do you guys want to see me play? And they'll tell me what's trending or like what they want to see.
What have you noticed? Do you notice anything that's like really trending, or does it always change constantly?
Oh, it changes constantly, all the time.
I know. I remember when the Squid Games was super big.
Right. I made like 7 videos on Squid Games.
And I bet they all did really well, right?
They did.
Yeah. Mm. Here you go. Anyone else? Like, how do you know what you want to?
I just play Bloxburg.
Because that's what you like, right? Yeah. So that makes sense. It's like what you like, what you do. What about you, Leah?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, I stick to my few games, but I do like to try out new games because a lot of games are really, like, you can really interact with your viewers and connect with them. So if I can get a 50-person server, I'll invite everybody and just have fun in there.
It's an interesting question. No, so back, actually, it's so funny because I was at VidCon in 2019, so I primarily post Adopt Me. That's like kind of what like I'm a bit known, quote unquote, for. When I was at VidCon 2019, the creator of Adopt Me hit me up and they're like, hey, we have like this pets alpha, like, I don't know if you want to play it. And I was like, sign me up, I'll do it. And I think it was VidCon, might have been a little bit earlier. And I was just like, sure, fell in love with it, kind of fell into my niche. And I just keep going because it's what I know. Who doesn't like to talk about what you know, what you're passionate about? It's easiest to do. It's fun.
Yeah, I love that. What about you, Ariel?
Yeah, I usually stick with Royal High, but occasionally I like to do like different games, like Cheese Escape, for example, just like random stuff that I just found. Yeah, I just find it really funny, and I think it would be interesting to see. So that's usually what I do.
I love that. Okay, I have a couple questions on avatars. I know, Alex, you touched on this earlier, that you love like fashion, clothing, and all that. So what do you feel like is the importance of avatars, like the ones that you make on Roblox, for you in general? Like, what? How would you feel?
I always dress it up just like me. I think it's important that you represent who you are as a person in your Roblox avatar. That's what I do. I'm always in all pink. But yeah.
I feel like a couple of you guys on stage love pink. Yeah. It's just my gut feeling.
Popular color.
Yeah.
We love pink.
Yes.
What does your avatar mean for you, Leah?
I mean, the cool thing about Roblox is you could dress up as anything you want. And that's the amazing thing about it. But I do absolutely love making my avatar look like me. It just feels more of an immersive experience being in Roblox. It's really cool.
I just have my avatar in something cute. I like to do meme stuff as well sometimes. So it's fun to like play around with the character designs and stuff. Yeah.
Yeah, that sounds good. What about you, Ariel?
I dress my character up as what I wish I could look like, in a sense, like blue hair, and she looks like a mermaid, of course. So it's me, but like, you know, upgraded.
I love that.
Yeah, so my avatar is also me, kind of like everybody else, except she has pink hair and now my hair's red. So I'm not sure if I'll update it or if I'll just keep a piece of me there forever. But I do really like the opportunity to create like the merch I have on staypeachy.com in real life. So these puffballs, I have them on Roblox, but I have them in real life. There's somebody wearing them right now. Hello. Hi. And if somebody can't purchase online, for example, maybe they are actually buying them on Roblox. It's more accessible. It's easier to get a hold of because it's, you know, more accessible. So I like to give that opportunity to viewers to wear like the Stay Peachy t-shirts, the merch and stuff. I can't, like, they maybe aren't allowed to purchase in real life.
Yeah. And have you guys, talking about that, Megan, thank you. Have you guys made your own clothing items on Roblox? Have you guys done that?
Yes.
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 Okay. So what has been, I guess two questions. What has been your favorite piece that you've made? And why have you?
So if you don't mind if I start.
Yeah, go for it, Megan.
So I started modeling skirts on Blender and I was like, oh, this is so fun. But then I rendered them out and I was like, oh, this is way too many polys, overcomplicated. Anyway, in VidCon 2019, I actually heard from the head of the STAR program that UGC was coming. So I kind of had an inside scoop. I got my iconic puffballs made, and I sat on them for months. And then when the UGC program launched, I launched those first. And I was the very first star creator to have a UGC item. Super, super proud about that. But those are my favorite item because...
What is UGC for those
of User-generated content. So UGC stands for user-generated content. It is content created by every individual. Anybody can do it. You can do it with Roblox Studio. Yeah, even you. With Roblox Studio or even on Blender. And then you can render it out into... Roblox, and you can wear it on your avatar in 3D. It's just a whole nother thing. And then you don't even get me started on layered clothing, like the newest, coolest thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I only have one item,
okay.
But it's basically this, but as headphones. So it's like the seashell mermaid headphones.
I love that. I need that. I need that totally. Yeah. What about you guys? Any items?
My favorite item, I think, my first item too, was I've always wanted a pink cat. So that was the first thing I made. Miss Misa.
Misa. Misa.
Yeah. I made a pink cat, and she just goes on your head like a hat.
Love that.
Yeah. I have two that I really like. The heart glasses, the heart pink glasses. I wear them a lot. And then also a cowgirl hat with little hearts on them. So I like those.
Yes, I love my iconic hair set, so I'll have my pink hair with my bedazzled headset. That's my favorite.
I love that. How do you guys feel about, like, I guess cutting out to that, like, new technology that comes on Roblox? I know Megan touched on this earlier about, like, layered clothing. Like, you know, what is layered clothing, and, like, how do you guys feel about new technology being added to customize your avatars even more?
I love that. I love customization. Like I said, I love the fashion. So having more options to like change how you look, I absolutely love that.
I think it's really expressive. So before, with the Roblox 2D avatar, you could have a set of pants, which some people used as like a suit, like a top and bottom, as well as a jacket on top. But now you can wear all those, plus a jacket or even pants. As you know, Ariel mentioned, it is deeper customization, but I'm actually really impressed. When I got to start messing with the UGC layered clothing, I was really impressed with how it layered. Like, I know we might not really, you can put on a t-shirt and then you put on a jacket and the jacket gets bigger. Like, it actually grows with your avatar and how many things you have underneath it, which I think is really interactive and cool. It really sets up for how immersive the entire world is becoming. I don't know if I can talk about what, like, the facial. Okay, but just so many really cool things are coming with Roblox. You know, we have experiences, concerts, like it's all getting so immersive and I just, so excited.
Yeah, awesome, thank you.
Oh yes, I love all the clothing. It really makes it easier to dress your character how you want to. And I felt like before, you know, you could just get the classic shirt, classic pants, but now you can add on to it and make it look even cute or even ridiculous. So
yeah, I love that. And I think that's what makes it fun is I kind of like the note that you guys have all touched on, which is the avatar is the way to make that you, whether that is a reflection of who you are in real life, who you want to be, or who you aspire or look up to be. And I love that. And yes. I think that how you said that gives the opportunity to even make it even more. And
right, extra.
Extra. What about you guys? You have?
I just like how realistic it looks, like the little sweaters and stuff like that. It looks very realistic and I really like it.
Yeah. Do you like it that sometimes it's starting to look more realistic?
Yes, not like the avatar version, but I like the clothes and stuff.
Okay, that's awesome.
Yeah, and exactly what they all touched on. It's like back in 2017, everything was so limited in Roblox. You couldn't really express yourself or dress up as yourself, but now it's come so far, and I'm just really excited to see where it's going to go next.
Yeah, I love that. I love that. Okay, so the next topic that I have for everybody is about friendship and the community. So, what is your favorite way to connect with your fans?
Definitely just like inviting them to a private server, doing the pageants in Royal High, doing little meet and greets. Like we pretend to have sleepovers in Bloxburg. It's so fun. That's my favorite.
I've never won a pageant and I'm upset.
Oh, no.
Probably the same thing. I like open up my neighborhood on Bloxburg, just let everyone join. We have like parties and stuff like that. So, yeah.
So this is crazy, but every now and then I have a group of people that I record with and we'll get into a game and I'll be like, hey, like, let's turn my joins on, which means that anyone can join. Yeah. And when I turn it on, like so many people come into the server and say hi.
Yeah, that's so awesome that they're just like, so we're ready.
Right. They're always watching.
They're always watching.
Of course, I agree with these three, you know, getting in servers with your viewers. It's like cheesy. I love being here, like seeing the real faces behind the avatars and behind the numbers. That's actually the most rewarding part to absolutely every single part of it. And I'm just really grateful that Roblox has helped facilitate like my career growth and stuff like that to allow me to be here on stage with all these amazing female creators and Ruben to meet some of you guys. It's my favorite part.
So basically every time I play Roblox, I have my join set to everyone. So anybody could join me anytime and I'll let people know like, hey, I'm gonna play Roblox. Here's the link, you can join me if you want. So I love that. I love being able to interact with my viewers.
I love that. And I think that that's super fun because it gets them to know you even more and to be able to get in there and be really immersed. So one of the cool things about Roblox is that it's inherently social. It's like a social platform. So who do you guys love to play with?
My viewers.
Your viewers? So your viewers.
Honestly, I really like to play with my husband, Zach, on weekends whenever he's not doing game development. So he's actually very integrated in the Roblox platform. He knows what game just released this weekend, last weekend. He knows the CCUs. He knows everything. So he'll be like, I just found this new game, and he'll show it to me, and we'll play together. We recently have been playing Gas Station Simulator together. I don't know if you guys know that one. You just work at a gas station.
I was gonna say, is it? Do you
so
work at
romantic?
A gas
station? Yeah, we run
that's
a gas station.
That's the perfect
station
date night.
Yeah, honestly, that's what we do. We play Roblox together, different simulators. We get in Discord call. He sits in his office. I sit in mine, and we just play Roblox.
Honestly, that's like couple goals right there. Like
that's it.
I play with six of my friends. Well, there's seven of us, but we call each other the squad, and they're the people that I... Yeah, the squad! And they are the people that I play with all the time. We'll find, like, random Roblox game, and it'll be, like, late at night, like, 2 a.m., and we'll all get on the Roblox game, and it's so fun.
I love that. I feel like that's the best parts. It's, like, when your friends at 2 a.m. and being like, right. Let's get on. What are we going to do? Who knows?
Let's just choose a game.
Let's just choose one.
Just close your eyes, pick one.
What about you?
No one that I know in real life plays Roblox, so I just play with random people on Roblox.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll play.
Yeah, it's fun because you could just, like, play with random people. I love getting Santa to play bingo with me. We love doing that. And my sister, like, literally everyone I try to get to play.
Yeah, I have, like, my niece. She always wants me to play with her, too. So it's always the fun thing where you know, you can connect with your real-life friends. You have Roblox friends that you end up making along the way, which I think is super fun. How about, do you guys ever do, like, meet and greets with your fans? I know a couple of you guys said that you open up your servers. Are there other ways that you connect with your fans?
Yeah. Yeah, private servers is a great way, and, like, I always love recording videos and be like, come with me, meet me in Bloxburg, and you're going to help me build a house. And then we just, like, all hang out in after, and that's really fun.
There's no other way that I do. I just, like, let them join, and yeah.
Yeah, just going onto my Instagram stories, posting a link, being like, join me, and then a bunch of people will join. And we kind of have, like, little mini meet and greets and, like, play with the fans every now and then. It'll just be totally random.
For me, I don't say always, that's like a, you know, most of the time have my joins on for followers. So if I go and adopt me and do a trading video, that gives viewers opportunity to be like, oh my gosh, like, hello. So they'll just come in, they'll jump in, they'll get into a trade with me, and there's a private message with the trade. So they'll start talking to me there, and I'm like, so grateful that it's like, wow, you decided to spend your time coming to try to find me? Like, totally mind-boggling. So yeah, it's that. Joins on for followers and... trading.
Yeah, so like I said, I usually have my join set to everyone, so anybody can join me at any time, and sometimes I get regular people that join me every single time, so I'm like, okay, this person really, you know, wants to support me, so then we end up becoming friends, and then they, you know, I'm sorry, I'm nervous.
Oh my gosh, no, you're doing amazing. So I have another question. Yes, give her a hand of applause. You're doing awesome.
You're amazing. Yeah.
So I have a quick question for you guys. What is the one piece of advice that you would give to any future Roblox creators who look up to you guys and really hope to maybe do content like you guys? Is there anything that you would love to say to them?
Yeah, what's really important is finding a game that you connect with. Like when I found Royal High, that was just so easy for me to make content on, and you just can never give up.
I would say just like start, because a lot of people just think about it and don't start. So just start somewhere and you'll probably, yeah.
You're going to have people that don't believe in you and that tell you that what you want is impossible. Don't believe them. Follow your dreams. You can do anything.
I love that.
I would say discipline and consistency are key. A lot of people say like, oh, I don't feel inspired today. It's not always about inspiration, unfortunately. It's about discipline. And if you keep it consistent, good things will happen. And that's all you really have to stick to. Of course, finding games that you love is super important, because that consistency, it doesn't go away. So you really want to make sure you love what you're doing and, you know, make it happen. Like OBS. Open Broadcasting System is what a majority of us use to record our screens. It's free. When I started posting on YouTube, I just took my iPhone and I would do vlogs or voice memos for a microphone, upload that. So there are ways to get started and get going for very, very low costs. Because I know a lot of people see the very intimidating gaming setups and the microphones and the lights. Like, you don't need all that to start. People love to just watch people that they relate to. So consistency, discipline, and just using the resources that you have available to you, even if you don't feel like they're good enough, they are good enough. Just get started.
So yeah, it's more accessible than ever to get started. And the main thing is to just never give up. If it's something that you're passionate about, and as long as you're not hurting anybody, no matter, regardless if people aren't supporting you, they say, oh, you shouldn't do this, you should never give up. And
yeah. No, of course. Don't worry.
You're doing amazing.
Thank you.
And yeah, you should, I mean, it's honestly takes a lot of courage to even be up on here.
It's her first panel. It's Ariel's first panel, Ariel, guys.
Yeah.
You guys are in the presence of history. History.
But it, and like you guys said, I love that. It's like, you know, you always are passionate about whatever you do. And I feel like for you guys, it is creating Roblox videos. And you guys, your passion, like seeing all of these wonderful people out here supporting you guys really shows how, like, you know, being your authentic self and really showing people like how you care and love, it really translates. And I think that's awesome. And I love hearing that, and it's awesome. So another thing would be like Roblox is always changing. There's like how we mentioned before, new technology, new innovation, even new experiences. What has been something unexpected that you've done on Roblox that you really have enjoyed?
I remember I went to a concert in Roblox, and that was so much fun. It was 24K Golden's concert, and it was seriously the coolest thing I've ever experienced on Roblox.
And like with that, why was that something that you never expected? Like what?
Well, he was there, and he was like connecting with us and talking with us, and he was so excited, and it was cool to like experience that, and it felt really immersive and awesome. And I was like, this is so cool. I like teared up because it was so cool.
That's awesome. What about you?
I'm just gonna piggyback off of that just because I can't think of anything, but the concerts were pretty cool. And also like with that, he was like friending everybody as well. It was a pretty cool experience, yeah.
I love that.
I'll have to agree. Concerts, like, you can bring a lot of people together at the same time to experience the same thing, and it's just so cool. It's like having a party in Roblox.
Yeah, I love that. Like, having a, you know, a little a virtual fun party with all your, you know, all these, like, hundreds of friends that you're just making. Yeah.
I have kind of, like, a dual part answer, so I'm going to pass to Ariel first.
Okay, Ariel.
That's okay.
Yeah.
I like the events. I'm not sure if they still go on, but things like egg hunt, where people work together, like, oh, we have to find, where's this egg? Or did you find that one? And I really like that, you know, you can interact with people.
Yeah, we love like a community, bringing the community together.
Yeah, so I feel like my husband told me about a keynote that Roblox did a bit ago and how their quote unquote major competitors, don't love that word, were actually not gaming platforms, but instead Netflix and entertainment platforms. That was really eye-opening to us because we're like, oh, Roblox, and that's shortly after they changed it from games to experiences. They're like trying to do more than just be a gaming platform. They're trying to bring experiences like concerts and stuff. I mean, oh my gosh. So to answer the question, things I never thought I would get to do. They invited me to go record a video with Paris Hilton. Like, I grew up idolizing her. So I got to sit next to Paris Hilton in a room and record Roblox. Like, that is crazy. Like, I never experienced something like that in my entire life. So it's just been kind of a huge whirlwind of all the possibilities and how many mega celebrities are interested in the platform.
Awesome. I love that. Since you mentioned Paris Hilton, you mentioned 24K Golden. I personally love Lil Nas X. The Lil Nas X concert, so epic. And so I want to know, what kind of other brands or musical artists would you love to see on Roblox? Let's start with Ariel. You're like,
I'm not really. I think I might be too old for this one.
You're not old.
No.
Like, who do you? What about
Ariana Grande?
Ariana, oh.
Please. Yes.
Come to Roblox. Yes. I love her.
Yes, I love Ariana. I need Ari. What did you say, Alex?
Please. Ariana, please.
Ariana, if you're watching like this, we need you on Roblox.
I would say Billie Eilish.
Billie Eilish, yes. I love Billie Eilish.
Justin Bieber.
Justin Bieber.
Yes. So my favorite artist actually came to Roblox, Poppy. Not a lot of people know about her, but okay, good. I was in the 0.01% of Poppy listeners, so I actually got to make a video with her. I got to talk to her for a bit, and I was like, oh my God, I don't mean to be like so weird, but I have to ask you a ton of questions. So that was me. So she came, but if I were to pick other artists, I really like Bring Me the Horizon. I think it'd be so cool if we had a rock concert.
Yes,
in Roblox, we haven't had any rock concerts yet.
Yeah, rock would be cool. Yeah.
No.
I mean, we had...
Why don't we? But that's more pop.
21 Pilots.
That's not rock. Like alternative, right?
It's alternative, yeah. It's a little bit.
On your metal.
But what about brands? I know we've had brands such as Gucci, Nike come on the platform. Are there any fun brands that you would love to see?
Chanel.
Oh, yeah.
I see the bag,
girl.
I second
that. Big fan.
Chanel would be fun. Anyone? I agree.
I think it'd be so cool if we could see like a collaborative like video game situation, like maybe Fortnite comes to the platform.
Wow.
And then they do something on Fortnite with Roblox. Like, I know it's totally like people like to guard their territory for whatever reason, but it's like, imagine like video game versus video game. Like, people like love that stuff, you know? So it'd be so powerful to have that type of crossover.
Yeah.
Bridge that gap.
Yeah, we should.
I'm gonna say the same thing. I think, you know, collaborating with multiple games, especially if they're similar in nature, that would be a really cool experience, I think.
Yeah, I love that. I think that would be good. You guys, what do you hope Roblox would look like in 5 years? You know, I've mentioned how it's been changing. There's a lot of new things. How would you like to see it grow in 5 years, 10 years in the future?
I would love for them to come out with, like, custom faces or something where you can just, like, you know, change it all yourself, make it look like you, have fun makeup. I would love that.
Probably just like an easier way to like develop, I guess. Just like a starter base just for like everybody. Because developing games is like a big thing as well.
I think a bigger friend limit so I can add everyone.
You're like, please, I want to be everyone's friend.
That's the main question I get asked. If it was unlimited, I would add everyone.
You heard it here first. We need a bigger friend list.
Yeah, I think it's already also rapidly evolving that I can't even imagine where it's going to be in 5 years because it's been so crazy in the past 1 year. But what I would like to see is more console support. So console players make up not even 5% of Roblox players. So I think it'd be really cool if Roblox was able to really dominate the gaming space by getting on PlayStation and Xbox and Nintendo, like the Nintendo Wii. Wii Switch. God, I'm an old person. I keep telling my husband, I'm like, are we gonna play Wii Sports? And he's like, it's not called that. It's called Switch Sports or something.
It's
I don't
on
know.
The Switch. We're on
I'm
the
like
Switch.
An old person now. Like I feel like my grandma. Like, oh, what are you guys doing on the rodeo phone? Anyway.
We said we have a Wii Sports fan still. So.
Oh, good. I'm right there with you.
Where do you see Roblox like in 5, 10 years? Like, what would you love to see?
I do believe that now they're coming out with like voice chat and it's in the works. I think that would be cool because it'll seem like more real to me. Yeah. Like it's not just a game, but you can actually communicate with people and it's like an avatar, but you're chatting with them. I really like that.
I just did voice chat for the first time like a week ago. I turned it on. I was super nervous. I even like recorded a video, went up 2 days ago, and I was like, oh, I'll join a voice chat only server. No one was on, and I was like, oh, okay, good. But then I actually went, and then people just started talking to me, and I was like, ooh, it's my time. And it was actually really fun. There's some funny people on Roblox, and I guess you just don't realize, like, wait, these are people.
Yeah.
Like, you're playing with people with thoughts and feelings and their own jokes. And I was like, I honestly was like, hey, you guys have to start telling jokes to make this video because I don't know what to say.
Yeah, that's very true. So I have a question. What other creators do you guys love, love to support, love to follow that you guys have? Yeah, creators.
I am Santa.
I am Santa. Yes. You kept mentioning you play bingo
Star
with her.
Star code I am Santa when buying Robux.
Does it have to be a Roblox creator?
No, no.
I've been watching Ryan, the guy with the penny, and I've been very interested in that, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Ryan Trahan. Right? Is that how you say it?
I love Dennis. I've been watching him since he started.
He's funny.
I love
His
Dennis.
His videos are funny. Yeah, mm-hmm. I love Sketch's videos, Dennis's videos. Those are really funny. But I'm more of a lifestyle watcher. Like, I watch, like, a lot of lifestyle vloggers, like Lore DIY, Remy Ashton, yeah. Stuff like that. So, yeah. Yes.
Not really sure.
It's okay. I like Creekcraft. I think he's cool.
He's doing something.
He's cool.
He's streaming.
Yeah. Okay, so another question. How do you guys choose? Because I know a lot of you guys have other platforms. It's just not YouTube. You guys also have TikTok accounts, Instagram, Twitters. How do you choose what you're going to post on what platform? How do you guys make that decision? Do you guys change the different content that you post on there? Or is it similar? Like, how do you guys decide that?
Yeah. I have an answer. It looks like some people have thinking faces on, so I don't know. I predominantly just do YouTube. I focus on YouTube. I don't quite think about the other platforms, but sometimes if I'm like, oh, that was kind of a funny video, that was a funny thought, I'll like crop it up and put it on TikTok. But when I decide what to put on TikTok, I kind of just see whatever's a trending sound, and I'm like, oh, that's a funny joke that relates to Roblox. I'll just throw that up. But I just really focus on YouTube because that's where people can really see my personality. They can see who I am. They can see who I like, because it's so hard, like, on TikTok to express who you are in such a short amount of time. So I feel like I actually have more followers on TikTok than YouTube, but I feel like my YouTube community is, like, stronger and more passionate, and they care more. So that's my main focus.
Yeah, same with me. I pretty much only do YouTube. I don't even post on any social media, and I know that's bad, so I need to work on that.
That's not bad. Social media can be really hard. It can be really hard. It can be toxic. Yeah. It's best to stay away from it.
I love social media.
Yeah, TikTok, I just like to do for fun. Like, I just think of it as, like, a hobby. I just focus on YouTube, and, yeah, just if I see something that's, like, a fun trend, I'll try it and post it.
I mostly post on YouTube, and then when I feel like it, I'll post on TikTok here and there.
Yeah, awesome. What do you like?
I don't use social media, really. I used to have a Twitter, deleted it. I haven't posted on TikTok in, like, a year. Oops.
Let's get you back on there. Okay, so another question that I received from a fan is, you know, the video game space, or, you know, even the technology space, it's very male oriented. It used to be very, very males dominating it. What advice would you give to other females, young female creators, who really want to be also, like, very involved in video games?
Sorry, I'm super passionate about this topic. Like, so if I could, so passionate, I can't, like, I could talk about it for, like, five ever. I used to work at GameStop. There was a lot of harassment there. I've never felt so welcome in a community as I have on Roblox. Like, I started streaming on Twitch, got some really inappropriate comments that made me uncomfortable, and honestly, I'm ashamed to say I shied away. It scared me off. I didn't like being objectified in the way I was. I didn't like being told that I can't like makeup and video games. It just didn't make sense to me. As somebody who has been playing video games since I was two, I just couldn't fathom that. But I never experienced that from the Roblox community once. And I think that that's really powerful. There's like an influx. There's like 41% more female devs in 2020, or 2020. Wow. What year are we in? 2021, last year. 41% rise in female developers. And I think that's really, yes, that's amazing. That is amazing. We're doing some work with some, I know. And I'm really happy to say that half of our WonderWorks staff are female. It's like 50-50. So it's just, it's a safe space. It's a great space. And I would say if anybody is telling you, like, you don't play games, it's like, try to build a Sims mansion. Get back to me. Like, you know, figure it out. Like, it's, you can throw it back if you want. I don't recommend that. Sorry, be nice to everybody. It just makes me a little sassy. So it's just, be yourself, keep doing what you do, because there is a community here, and there is a community on Roblox for women and girls in gaming, and I am so proud to be a part of this community that is so welcoming, and there is a space for you. You just have to find it.
Thank you. Awesome.
Yeah, definitely. I feel like anyone that says anything is just jealous.
Jealous.
They're just completely jealous. Just keep going. People are going to be mad at you for winning, succeeding, and they'll just say, oh, you're only popular because you're a girl and it's easy. No. Women can be really amazing at games, too. So just keep going.
Can I add something?
Yeah, go for it.
I feel like a lot of, like, water gating can come from, like, so it's like, girls, we're pretty, right? We all look good. We're all pretty. So I feel like a lot of men, when they try to push people out, like, women out of gaming, it's because we feel like they're coming for something that they have. They want to protect their territory, something that they are so native to, or that they feel like has been theirs for a while. So it is just that. It's jealousy. It's threatened. They're feeling threatened. They feel like, oh, they're coming onto this one thing that I have. But really, there's room for everybody to game. There's room for everybody to wear makeup. There's room for everybody to do anything you want. We don't choose who we like to be. We don't choose what we want to do. We don't choose what we enjoy. We just do it.
Yeah, I love that. Thank you. We're almost out of time, but we have a few more questions.
Monopolizing. No, I'm passionate about the topic.
Megan, thank you so much for that. We love that. What would you love to tell your younger self? What is something that you would love to tell your younger self, Alex?
I would like to hug myself, little me who didn't believe in myself. It's going to be okay, Alex.
Just to start, like I said previously, I just waited and hesitated, so I wish I just started when I wanted to start.
I would tell myself that everything is going to be okay, and don't let anybody tell me not to chase my dreams, because I can't tell you how many people told me that I wouldn't be successful in what I do, and like you get made fun of a little bit, but just keep going. Yeah. keep going.
I don't know. That's a really loaded question. Super emotional. I might start crying. I won't. I'll hold it together. When I was in the fifth grade, and I feel like a lot of my audience is in fifth grade, I felt really alone, and I wrote a lot of...
It's okay. Thank you.
Maybe I'll skip. I wrote a lot of diary entries that made my mom cry. She read them. And I just want to say that you should never think about opting out of the amazing experience that is life, because there is so much more out there. When you're 10, your whole life is your peers and your bullies, and it's just, there's such a great life. You're doing amazing. Sorry. There's just such a great life out there, and I don't want anybody to give up on themselves, because I don't. I know if I would have given up on myself, I wouldn't have been able to impact the lives I have today. It's really important to me that everybody knows that you're not alone. And we all feel anxious sometimes. We all feel afraid and alone, and we feel like nobody is experiencing what we are, but we all are. And it just reach out, okay? Reach out. Reach out to any of us. We're all here for you guys. And I just want you to know to keep going and keep doing it, because you can achieve anything you want to achieve.
Thank you, Megan. Thank you. Ariel?
Same. Honestly, the same. I've been in the same situation pretty much my whole school year. I've always been a loner. I've never really had any real friends. And so when I became an adult, I'm like, okay, I'm tired of always being alone, and I never really talked to anybody. So being here today is like a huge accomplishment for me, because I've never really spoken out loud. So in school, I'm like, okay, I don't really have any friends. I'm tired of this. Let's start, you know, making YouTube videos so I can talk more. And now I'm here today, and I wouldn't be here today if I gave up. So my main, you know, sentence I want to say is that you should never give up.
Thank you. Okay, thank you guys so much for taking the time. We're going to just do one final thought. So if everybody, we're going to go around. If you have any last comments, thoughts, anything you would like to say, we're going to start with Leah.
Just thank you all so much for being here. I can't express how grateful I am. You all make me so happy. I never thought I would be in this position in life. And I'm just always going to be grateful. Love you guys.
Same thing, thank you. And also, this was a great experience. I really enjoyed it. Yeah, thank you.
I would not be here if it wasn't for you. So thank you so much for your support. I can't say it enough. Wish I could give everyone a huge hug. Thank you. I love you.
Thank you all for being here. It means a lot that you came to support all of us. It does mean a lot. If you ever have dreamed of being a YouTuber, being on stage, or, you know, doing what we do, all I have to say is there's a ton of resources out there, free YouTube tutorials that tell you how to get started, and just start. I know it seems scary. I know it seems like nobody's gonna watch. I know it seems like I feel stupid talking to myself. You're not. Please start. Please take this, bet on yourself. Bet on maybe changing your life for the better. Give it a shot. If you don't like it, that's okay, but all you have to do is start.
So I just wanna say thank you guys so much. Thank you so much for the support. Again, I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for your support. And I just wanna say, if you're feeling alone or lonely like me, you can always contact me, and I'll be your friend.
Awesome. Thank you, guys. Since you guys know I love social media, hello, we're going to take a quick selfie with everybody. So we're going to just get ready, get posing.
Are we
so,
close?
Yeah, we're going to get okay. close.
I think I might have sweated, though. I'm like kind of sweaty.
It's okay. Don't look too close.
Okay.
Okay. Do you
want to
do it? Can you do it?
Oh, my gosh. Would you say my hands are long?
No, I'm like, you're taller.
I'm taller.
Okay, is everyone ready? Get close together. Oh yeah, you're doing that. Yeah, perfect.
Is everyone?
Okay. Pose. Okay, one, two.
Wait, are we doing with the viewers?
Where's
yeah,
the
we're game with
All right, that. So let's stack this way.
Okay.
Sorry. Yeah, that is amazing. Leah, come in.
Okay, smile, everyone.
Okay, I think I got
awesome. Yeah, that's good. Thank you, everyone. Thank you guys so much. Have a great rest of your VidCon.